ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ we are blessed to be here and listening to veer ji harinder he began with what is guru nanak followed by asha the politics of guru nanak and then sorry by jasleen the politics of guru nanak and then by asha poetics of guru nanak and in the end it was beautifully summed up by dr manjeet that when you hear all this what is guru nanak and his poetics and his politics and all those things what you utter what spontaneously you know comes through your mind comes through your mouth is wah guru and wah guru moving forward I'm just going to take you to Jasleen has taken you through Asa Ki Waar, one of the compositions of Guru Nanak. Harinder shared some of the beautiful verses from Guru Nanak himself and of the other contributors. And Asha shared some of the beautiful Persian verses from Guru Granth Sahib. I'm going to take you to Japji, one of the masterpieces of Guru Nanak. And while doing so, we are going to just have a quick look at Guru Nanak Bani. We are going to have a look at what his this masterpiece Japji is all about, its structure, its theme, and then to the main topic, gems, jewels, and pearls in the mind. And to correlate, I would like to borrow these few words from Jasleen's slides. He ended up with, how do we identify with Naam? And how do we adopt good behavior? And in the end, the last quote was, the better or the happier world. These gems, jewels, and pearls that we are going to look through, some of the verses of Japji Sahib, are going to help us find the clues to these. How do we identify with the Naam culture? How do we adopt a good behavior? Guru Nanak Bani, just to say in very simple words, the entire Guru Granth Sahib comprises of 6,000 compositions, 6,000 hymns, 6,000 Shabads. I'm just making it simpler. Otherwise, the number is something like 5,600 and so on. So just remember 6,000 Shabads are there in Guru Granth Sahib. And when we talk of Guru Nanak Sahib, so he has composed around 1,000 Shabads. So out of 6,000, 1,000 are of Guru Nanak. And there are total 31 major ragas used in Guru Granth Sahib, rag, we call them. Dr. Manjeet is sitting here from Music World. And out of those 31 main ragas, Guru Nanak used 19 of them. And some of the compositions you might be aware of Guru Nanak is Japji, Siddh Ghosht, and one of the Baramaha, if you can recall, and three of the odes, ballads. One of them is Asa Ki Waar. Okay, so we are going to talk about Japji. Japji is one of the most beautiful, important, and a masterpiece of Guru Nanak, which, when we look at its structure, it begins with Ek Onkar Satnam Kartapurkh until Gur Prasad. We call it Mool Mantra or invocation. Further, there is a slok called Ad Sach, Jugad Sach, and followed by 38 Paudiyas. Paudiyas are like steps that we move on and on and on. And in the end, there is again a slok, Pavan Guru Pani Pita. So that's the structure of Japji Sahib. To begin with this quote, and I think something wrong with this, the quote is of Paisan Tok Singh, which has been translated and captured by Sardar Kapoor Singh. And he says, this comes from a tradition that Japji, it was like believed and Sikhs were so, you know, attuned to this that every Sikh was supposed to not just read Japji every day, but memorize it, Japji. And if somebody hasn't done it, he will feel like that whole day that something is missing. And the same emotions are being, you know, shared by another poet, another one of the beautiful, eminent, scholarly person we have, Professor Puran Singh. He also says the same. He says, I feel like, you know, if I haven't read Japji, I'm dying. Something is really, you know, missing. So these words of these beautiful people and these devout people, those who are like, you know, they are sharing their personal experience about Japji Sahib, to me, they are enough to tell us that Japji is one of the so soul-touching and beautiful verse of Guru Nanak. That at least, if we are not able to read any further Bani of Guru Sahib, at least we read it, Japji Sahib. If not full, maybe you can read half of Japji Sahib, you can begin with Mool Mantar, you can just, you know, complete five podiums. So this has been a tradition that Sikhs must love Japji of Guru Nanak. Sikhs must love Guru Nanak. We have been, you know, talking about since morning. Another thing I would like to say, you know, this, I used to say that one of the, there are so many dates, so many, important dates in history. So one of them is 1469. What happened on 1469? I used to say the Sikhs must remember at least this one date, this one year. What's that? 14? Say once more, 14? Look, this is where we come from. 1469 is Guru Nanak's birth year that we are celebrating 550 years of the Guru Sahib. The theme of Japji Sahib, I think you all might be remembering this. The first stanza of Japji begins with Socha Soch, and the last two lines give us the theme of Japji Sahib, which is Kib Sachyara Hoiye, Kib Kude Tutte Paal. In simply put, it says, how to be truth-oriented. How to be, you know, oriented towards this good behavior, towards Naam culture, towards divinity, and how to overcome the obstacles or the whatever, you know, which separates me from this Naam culture, from this divinity. And then the answer is given in the next line, but in a coded form. The answer is, Hukam Rajai Challana Nanak Likhya Nar, which means only by attuning yourself to the will of the divine. But what is this will of the divine? So in this presentation, what we are going to do is, we are going to possibly, you know, look at, and we are going to find that the clue is for all these questions, how to be truth-oriented, how to overcome what separates you from this truth orientation, how to be aligned, yourself aligned with the will of the divine, with the divine will, and how to be able to receive grace of the divine, and further, again, how to identify with the Naam, how to be partner to the, we are calling, you know, Guru Nanak Raj, 550 years of Guru Nanak Raj. So how to partner with this Guru, the concept of the principle of Guru Nanak Raj? How to partner with this idea of oneness, ekonkar? So I think what I'm going to share now with you is going to help us to you know, align all these questions, and you will see they are all interlinked, and the answer lies in the sixth body. One of the beautiful words in the sixth body is, which has been taken into the title of this presentation, that is Mat Vich Ratan Jawahar Manik Je Ik Gur Ki Sikh Suni. The Punjabi words are Ratan Jawahar Manik, gems, jewels, and pearls. The Guru says, Guru Nanak Sahib's Bani, Japji Sahib, it says, if you listen to the Guru's teaching, if you listen to the Guru's Bani with love and devotion, and it's listening, it's not just hearing, what happens? These Ratan, Jawahar, Manak, they are produced within your mind. They are produced within your intellect. Mat vich pragat ho jande ne. Now the question is, what are these Ratan, Jawahar, Manak? And I'm sure you have been reading Japji for so many times. Maybe that sometimes when we read, we are not so focused. So All these verses you might have heard many times, but maybe you haven't really thought of that, oh, these are the Ritanjavahar Manik, right? To begin with, can you just think of what might be the first Ratan? Ratan Jawahar Manak. What might be the first of them? Anyway, so here we go. The first is in the fourth pauri. Sacha Sahib Sach Nae Pakhya Pao Apa. Also, this presentation is going to help you come up with, you might like to note down somewhere in your phones or in your memory, that some of the beautiful terms used in Gurbani, which are like which are going to help us to find out what are these Ratan Jawahar Manaks, and also some of the beautiful verses from Gurbani. So first of them, Guru says, is Pao. What is Pao? Pao is love. And you will be, astonished and amazed to look into it. This Pao in Japji itself is used not just once, twice, thrice, four times. So then this in itself shows how important is this love. And when we say love in Gurbani and in Sikhi's perspective, love includes devotion. So love and devotion. Here, rather, the Guru says, because Gurbani is in a poetic language, so Guru says, using it in this way, that do you know what is the language of the divine? If you want to converse with the divine, how do you do? In which language? Persian? Sanskrit? Arabic? Punjabi? In Guru's words, and that's so beautiful, to say, he says, the language of the divine is Pao. Is love. It means whatever you say, whatever you read, you do your prayers, you do your ardas, but if they are lacking love, if they are lacking devotion, they are not heard. And this reminds me of, the one Sakhi of Guru Nanak Sahib when he was asked to come into a mosque, Sultanpur Lodhi, and he was asked by the Qazi to utter prayer with him, namaz. Guru went there, and this is what he concluded with. The last words, inscribed in the Janam Sakhis are, Qazi Sahab, Qazi asked the Guru, why didn't you say prayers with me? The Guru said, your prayers are not accepted. Qazi Sahab, tuhadi namaz kabool nahi hoi. Kabool is accepted, not heard. Why? Because it was missing love. It was missing focus. It wasn't having the devotion that it should have had. The next line is same, the next pauri, and much more beautiful. It says, gaviye, suniye, man rakhiye, pao. Pao is love. When you have to listen to the Guru's bani, when you have to sing it, and you must, you should sing, you should, utter it from your mouth and you should listen to it, but with love, with power, again. The next is, in the 21st pauri, much more beautiful. What happens if somebody listens to it with love and devotion? The answer is given, sunya, manya, man kita, pao. Third time, the word pao, love. Sunya, manya, man kita, pao. The one who has listened to it, the bani we can say, the naam we can say, and accepted it. Manya is to accept, to put those things into practice, to adopt. And loved it, cherished it within his mind. What happens to him? What does he achieve? Sunya, manya, man kita, pao. The next talk says, antargat tirath mal nao. It's like he doesn't now need to go to any external places of bathings or pilgrimages. He has bathed within. He has had a spiritual pilgrimage within himself. So this is what is the importance of love and devotion. The last one is in the last pauri, Panda Pao. You remember this? 38th Pauri. And again, in Guru's words, so beautiful to say, he's not saying, make the panda as your pao. In place of saying that, he's saying, let the love be the panda. Panda pao. Let you know, this love be, love itself be your, be the panda that you have to put naam into it. So, I mean, just in Japji Sahib, which runs from page 1 to 8, 8 pages, 4 times the word, literally the word pao has appeared. If you have to add furthermore, so there is another word rang in 20th Pauri. Mat vich, what it says is, pariyai mat papa kai sang, o to pai, naamai kai. Again, this is, I mean, to me, they are so beautiful. In place of saying, and he, I mean, if you say this way, that's also correct. That's the filth, that the dirt we are having within the mind can be washed with naam. It's correct to say, isn't it? But the guru says, in place of saying it can be washed with naam, he says, it can be washed with love of naam. Which means again, if love is not there, then even the naam cannot wash the dirt of your mind. Par ye mat papan kai sang, o to pai, how? Naam hai kai? Naam de prem naal tupni yao. With the love of the divine, with the love of naam. Let's move ahead. So, I mean, 4 times literally the word pao, 5th times it appears in the name as rang, which again means, rang means color, literally, but prem, love. Then, pauri number 8 to 11. 4 pauriyan are called like sunayan diyan pauriyan, listening. And the 10th pauri has a beautiful verse which has all these 3 in one line. Gem, a jewel, and a pearl. They are sunayan, sat santokh gyan, sat santokh and gyan. These are mat vich ratan jawahar manik, which can be, which are produced within your mind. Sat is truthful conduct. The guru says if there is, the foundation of life has to be truthful conduct. And the next is santokh, contentment. In Sukhmani it says, you might have earned, you know, millions and billions of dollars. If there is no santokh, the mind is never satisfied. Bina santokh, nahi ko raja. This is like a universal truth. If there is no contentment, there is never satisfaction in life. So that's what is, I mean, the significance of santokh. The last one is gyan, wisdom. We have been talking since morning. And the similar verse is there in the end of Guru Granth Sahib, if you remember. While reading Sodar Ras, we used to, you know, we read, Munda apna thal vich tin vastu payo. What are those 3? Thal vich tin vastu payo, sat, santokh, vicharo. Vicharo and wisdom are synonymous to each other. Because vichar vi kada karna, wisdom da. Vichar of wisdom. So, I mean, they are so important, and I further would, you know, would like to connect them to the 3 golden principles of Guru Nanak Sahib. Taram di kirt karni, vand ke chakna, and naam japna. So sat is basically honest earning, you know, truthful behavior, truthful conduct. That is the foundation that you should earn. No corruption, no bribery, no cheating. And santokh can be related with vand ke chakna. Because in true sense, you can only vand ke chak when you have this little bit contentment within yourself. If you're greedy, then even while you might be, you know, sharing with other people, you are wanting a shak, but it is maybe to have, you know, to ask for furthermore, or maybe with some other intentions. So truly speaking, contentment and wanting a shakna are, again, complementary to each other. And gyan, vichar, that's synonymous to naam jap, naam vichar, reflect on the divine, contemplate on naam. So they are all synonymous. So again, Sat Santokh Gyan, this is how we can relate them. Body number 16, much more interesting. And interesting in the way the guru puts them, you know, the way he describes them. So the line here goes with, again, there are three, in two lines, Taram, Daya, and Santokh. Tol, Taram, Daya ka poot. The beautiful thing is, the guru is saying, suppose if I ask you what comes first, Taram or Daya, I think many of us will say, or maybe most of us will say, Taram should be the first, isn't it? But look at here, what he says. What comes first? Daya. Because he says, Taram is actually literally saying son of Daya, which means if there is, and this compassion Daya is again very close to love. If there is no love, if there is no compassion, in true sense again, there can't be true Taram. You know, it is just maybe to show off or just externalities and kind of things. It's not the true Taram. The true Taram comes where compassion is there. In the way, first there has to be compassion, love, and then there has to be Taram. One of the translations of Taram is righteousness. I've used it deliberately because just to connect with gems, jewels, and pearls. Then comes Santokh again. So these three, again, the guru is, see how guru is putting them in. He says these three are, you know, they are the one who has upheld the order of this nature. There has been a myth, what is sustaining the earth? What is supporting the earth? And there have been so many mythical views. One was like some bull over there is, you know, holding this earth on his singer, on his horns, something like that. Guru say no. And this is again so beautiful that the virtues like as such, compassion, Taram, Santokh. And to me, whenever in the world there is, you know, decrease in the proportion of these three virtues or such virtues, there are disasters, there are disruptions, there are violence, there is lack of peace, lack of love, kind of things. And if you can increase these three in our own lives, in a family's life, in a society, you will have more peace, you have more comfort, and you will have more happiness. So to say, be compassionate to others, be satisfied within yourself, and lead a righteous life. So these three, the guru says, you know, are the things which are upholding the order of nature. Then we come to body number 27. 27, 28, and 29 are in a conversation with yogis. Guruji is using the symbols the yogis used to have into their ears, on their bodies, and so on, and replacing them with, again, Ratan Jawahar Manik. So these are the Ratan Jawahar Manik. So he is again replacing them with Manda, with Santokh, in place of putting, you know, into your ears some sort of earrings the yogis used to wear. He says, have Santokh. And Sram Pat Choli, the yogis never worked. They did not earn, so they used to go for begging, asking people to, you know, give them to eat and so on. The guru says, in place of that, live a life of labor, effort, diligence, work. And that should be, you know, your bag and your bowl. And lastly, again, the yogis used to apply ashes to their bodies in place of putting on beautiful clothes or, you know, things. So guru says, you know, replace them with contemplation. Dhyan. And the dhyan of in the Sikhi term, dhyan is not like, you know, sitting somewhere and meditating on one, something like that. Dhyan is, you know, such a state of mind where you are always in your mind is the idea of this oneness. The idea of the divine pervades all, through all times, through all places, through all people, through all colors, through all directions, through all foods, and through every and everything. So that's what is dhyan. So again, in just in one body, in one line, three of them are there. These are gems, jewels, and pearls. So santok, sram, mehnat karni, and dhyan. Next pauri, two more. Pugat gyan. And the next is, again, very beautiful. Pugat, pugat is food. And this is interesting, you know. Nowadays, the Sikhs, you know, we have missed this so beautiful teaching of a guru. Guru is saying, my Sikhs, for them, wisdom is the food. How many of us can say, yes, that's the case with me? We have replaced this wisdom with our variety of langars, isn't it? Even in the Gurdwaras and the community gatherings, we are more focused on langar in place of wisdom. And the Guru is saying this to yogis, those who used to have pandara and a kind of langar in those times. He says, the Guru Nanak, you know, he's saying, my Sikhs, for them, pugat is pojan. And how do they share this pojan with others? Again, very, very interesting. I mean, they love to share it with others. They love to distribute this wisdom with others, you know, to others. But how do they do it? The distributor is it some sort of force, some sort of rule, some sort of compulsion? No, it is compassion. That if you want to share your values with others, this is out of compassion. Because you love the guy. You want that the experience that you had, the you know, the beauty that you had in your life through these beautiful teachings of the Guru must be shared with others because you love the other person. You are showing a sort of compassion for him. So this is again to me very, very beautiful. The wisdom is the ideal food and compassion is the ideal distributor. And this is very close to Professor Puran Singh's line here, and he says, today, and this today refers to 100 years back. When he wrote, then it was, now it's 2019, right? It was 1919. So when the Sikhs were celebrating 450 years of Guru Nanak, this is when he wrote. And he says, if you ask any Sikh child to choose between japji and bread, what will he do? And we need to ask this question to ourselves, isn't it? Or we have so changed in 100 years? I think we need to reflect. Are we still there? He says, no. Guru Nanak's child, Guru Nanak's Sikh, if he's asked to choose out of these two, he will go for Japji. That is saying he will go for the Guru. He will go for the love, for his love, the Guru. So, I mean, this is so beautiful what Guru have said here, Pugat Gyan Daya Pandara. And then, pauri number 34 to 37, these are like, this is a bazaar of now gems and jewels. So far, there have been shops, one after one. Now, here is a big bazaar. Why I'm calling this big bazaar? Because pauri number 34 to 37, four pauris, and they are related with Panj Khand. Right? Loosely speaking, we call them five realms, or you can call them five stages, or five states of mind, or whatever. To me, the interesting thing is, because they are five, right? They are talking about something, five steps maybe. They might have been titled like one, two, three, four. And this has happened many times in Gurbani, you know, the Pahla, Dujja, Tijja, even when the Lama we read, so it comes Pahli Lam, Dujri Lam, and so on. But here, it to me might be, you know, the Guru has did it deliberately. He has titled these five khands in these four paudinya with gems, jewels, and the pearls that he referred in paudi 6. Matvich Ratan Jawahar Manak Je Ek Guru Ki Sikhsul. And these are Taram. So the first khand he says is, I would like to call it Taram. The second one, Gyan. Third one, Sram. Fourth one, Karam. The next one, Sach. Sach here, you know, refers to truth. the eternal, capital T. So translating them into English, righteousness, param, wisdom, effort. And you can note how many times they are being, some of them are coming again and again and again, right? And grace, this has been captured here first time in my slides, but otherwise it comes six times in Gurbani. There are six verses in Guru, in Japji itself, which use the word nadar or karam, grace. So important is grace. And lastly, truth. Satya khand vasa nirankar, the realm or the state where the divine, you know, is like so infused within you, in your personality, it looks like that he is really pervading through me and through all of us. That state. Okay, the last pauri, 38, is like a big mall now. Because in this pauri itself, the last pauri, 38, the whole pauri is like, maybe you might have missed all those virtues, all these qualities, all these attributes, the Ratan Jawahar Manik before, right? Because most of the times when we read Japji, what happens? We start reading it. The only we come to know that, oh, it has been completed when it is Salok, Pavan, Guru, Pani, Pita. ਉਦੋਂ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗਦਾ ਵੀ ਹੈ ਜਪ ਜੀ ਖਤਮ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਸੋ ਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਮਾਈਟ ਹੈਵ ਥੌਟ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦਿਸ ਇਸ ਵਾਟਸ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਹੈਪਨ ਵਿਦ ਸਮ ਆਫ ਅਸ ਸੋ ਹੀ ਹੈਸ ਕੈਪਚਰਡ ਮੋਸਟ ਆਫ ਦੀਸ ਕੁਆਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਅਗੇਨ ਇਨ ਜਸਟ ਵਨ ਪੌੜੀ ਉਹਦੇ ਸਾਰੀ ਪੌੜੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੁਆਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਹੀ ਕੁਆਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਐਂਡ ਦੇਰ ਹੈਜ਼ ਬੀਨ ਅ ਮੈਟਾਫਰ ਯੂਜ਼ਡ ਆਫ ਅ ਗੋਲਡ ਸਮਿਥ ਰਾਈਟ ਦੀ ਪੌੜੀ ਗੋਜ਼ ਜਤ ਪਾਹਾਰਾ ਧੀਰਜ ਸੁਨਿਆਰ ਅਹਰਣ ਮਤ ਵੇਦ ਹਥਿਆਰ One of the tools that the goldsmith uses, and one of the Jawahar Manik, one of the gems, one of the pearls. Here you go. The goldsmith has a furnace, has an anvil, has a hammer, has a bellows, fire, and a pot to put some water into it. The guru is, you know, in parallel to these things, he says self-restraint, like self-discipline, not a discipline which is being imposed by someone else. It has to come from within yourself, you know? And then patience is coming first time, but is very close to contentment. And intellect, mat. And the beautiful thing here is the mat in, you know, the intellect is being used as the anvil and wisdom as the hammer. That you need wisdom to hammer your mat to cleanse it. But what happens? I mean, what normally we Sikhs are doing today, we are doing the other way around. We are hammering wisdom, we are hammering gyan with the use of our intellect. Yeah. All the, you know, the social media kind of things you see, you know, all the controversies, all those things are that's the way we are doing it. We are hammering on wisdom through our mind. Like Guru Sahib ne kiya hi nahi. Let your mat, your intellect, your mind be put down and hammer it with wisdom. So here we go. And lastly, again, the fire. Fire is hard work, effort. That's the actual word is used there is tap. Sorry, agan. Right? So agan, tap are very close to each other. So agan or tap, what kind of tap you need is hard work. That's tap for Sikhi, in Sikhi. That's the tap for Sikhs. And lastly, again, the pot. The goldsmith used to have some water into it. And here it's like you have to pour amrit into it, nam into it. And that pot is again panda. And as told you before, it's not panda should be made of love. No. There's a difference in saying panda should be made of love. No. He says, no. Let the panda itself be love. This is so beautiful. So this is here you go. You know, I have captured some of the main verses through these paudiyan, which help us to relate what are those mat vich ratan jawahar manik je ik gur ki sikh sohi. When we read Japji, or when we read any bani, right? When we are listening to gurus, any of the words or teachings, that's the idea. That guru says these has to be produced. A guru is saying these are produced. To me, these are like the guru is giving us an assurance, a warranty, that this must happen. If it's not happening means something is wrong. True or not? Because Guru has said, this is what's going to happen. These Ratan Jawahar are to be produced from within your mind when you're listening to the Guru's teachings. So, ye hona chahida. Okay, to capture them all here, Jat, Sat, Tiraj, Pao in the last pauri, we can loosely translate it, divine awareness, literally it's fear, and Pratit, faithfulness. In Sikhi, you know, the Tolstoy has said a beautiful quote. He says, faith is not faith, but faithfulness. So that's what it is in Sikhi as well. A Sikh's faith in the Guru, in the Guru's wisdom is as such. So they all have appeared once in Guru Granth Sahib in Japji. And here you go, Daya, Tyan, both two times. Taram, Saram, and Santokh, three times each. I mean, look at them. Just in Japji itself, these words, these terms are being used twice, thrice. And look at here, love and Gyan, wisdom. How many times? Four times. So what are they saying to us? Now you can relate all these to how to identify with Naam. How to live in this oneness, how to be partner to this Guru Nanak Raj, how to adopt a good behavior, how to build, you know, or help build a good society, a good family, a good personality, a good life. And this good life in Sikhi is like successful life, accomplished life, happy life, a blissful life. How do you do that? So this is the answer is here. Kev sache ara hoi hai. To put them in simple words, this is how. You have to acquire, you have to develop, you have to cultivate, you have to cherish these Ratan Jawahar Manak when you are reading Japji or you're reading any of the Bani. And look at them, you know, to me they are, when I noticed them first time, they were really so amazing. Oh my God. These words are appearing, you know, so many times again and again and again throughout Japji. And lastly, this is what makes, or this is what comprises Naam. Sometimes be a puzzle, what's Naam? So put all these together, this makes Naam. The last two lines of Japji, the slok is Pavan Guru, the last two lines are Jinni Naam Tyaya. Tyaya is, in Punjabi, Tyaya is Tyan Vich Lianda. To bring into your focus. Our Tyan is just to not just to meditate upon it. No. The thing that you are meditating on, the thing that you are reflecting on, must become part of your mind, your consciousness. So tyaya is jada tyan vich aya. Jado naam tyan vich a gaya. And that should be then 24 hours. Not just in the morning or in the afternoon. So jinni naam tyaya gaye masakkat kaal, Nanak, then they are not just freed themselves. Freedom. Harinder Singh was saying, you know, the freedom, that's what the Guru asked from the Divine. So here you go. He says, not only they are freed, they are then able to free others. Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki.